In this class, we are going to discuss about CMOS NAND gate. In the last classes, we discussed about designing of same NAND gate by using PMOS and NMOS. In this class, we are going to discuss the designing of NAND gate by using CMOS logic. So, as you know that CMOS is the combination of PMOS and NMOS, as PMOS is taken as pull up transistor and NMOS is taken under pull down. So, here same for designing CMOS NAND gate also, PMOS NAND is considered upside. So, NMOS NAND is considered as pull down. So, here you can observe this is PMOS NAND gate and this is NMOS NAND gate. Both are cascaded in vertical like this, then it will form CMOS NAND gate. Now we will see it will works as CMOS NAND or not. So here for that I am considering same AB values here, A, B and your transistors. So that means Q1, Q2, Q3, Q4 and your output voltage V0. So see, when your output V0 is equivalent to 1 means whenever it is connected to VDD by any way, then only your output is equivalent to 1. Whenever your output is connected to ground, whenever it is connecting to ground even though it is connected to VDD, see here, don't confuse for PMOS, NMOS and all this. So, here whenever you take an output in middle, so whenever it is connected to ground, so even though it is connected for VDD, it will shows you 0. So now see here, so the combinations are 00, 01, 10 and 11. That means you know that for PMOS, so this is PMOS, PMOS will on for 0 and off for 1. Like that NMOS will on for 1 and off for 0. So, you know that Q3 and Q4 are NMOS and Q1 and Q2 are PMOS. These two are PMOS transistors and these two are NMOS transistors. So, this is NMOS. So, now I am just writing switch offs on and off values of this transistors or NMOS and PMOS. So, whenever A equal to 0, B equal to 0. Whenever A equal to 0, B equal to 0, both PMOS are going to on. That means, so Q1 on, Q2 on. Same low voltage if we given to NMOS, then those are going to off. So, any MOSFET is off means it will be open circuited. Here, these two transistors are off means here you will get a open circuit path and here these two PMOS are on means here you are having short path like this or like this. Then in this case your output is going to cut with this ground and this is going to connect with your source voltage. In this case you are getting 1 at output. So now in this case, second case, 01 condition. So in 01 condition your Q1 is going to on and your Q2 is going to off. As that is PMOS, for PMOS if you given high voltage that's going to off. Reverse case, in NMOS if you given high voltage then Q4 is going to on. And here A is 0, then this NMOS is going to off. So here NMOS is going to off for 0 and NMOS is going to on for 1. Now you can see the connection, Q1 is on, you are having short path like this, Q1 is on and your Q2 is off, that means here you are having open circuit and here you can observe your Q3 is off, that means here you are having open path. By this open path your output is going to cut with this ground, even though your Q4 is short circuited. As Q3 is open circuited, your path is going to cut with output. Then this output is going to connect with VDD through Q1. See, Q1 is on means you are having short circuit. So, now this output is going to connect through Q1 to VDD. So, anyway it is connected to VDD means you are getting high output. So in next case, 10 case, in this case your first PMOS is going to off and the second PMOS is going to on because we provided 0. Reverse of that, if you provided 1 here, Q3 is on, and as you provided 0 here, Q4 is off. That means NMOS will off for low voltage. So now you will see. So here your second transistor is on, that means here you are having short path, and here coming to here, so this is on and this is off. That means Q3 is on but Q4 is off. From output to here you are having short path, when coming to here you are having open path. By this open circuit your connection is going to lost from V0 to ground. Then this V0 is going to connect with this VDD through this Q2 PMOS. So then when it is connected to VDD here itself, here also you are going to get 1 at output or high voltage at output. In case of 1-1, that means both PMOS and NMOS are given with 1 in both input case. That means so A is equivalent to 1, B is equivalent to 1. So for this both PMOS are going to off, both NMOS are going to on. Both PMOS are going to off means you are going to lose your connection from output to source voltage, and both NMOS is going to on means you are going to get short circuit path from output to ground. These two NMOS are going to on means here you are having short path from output to ground and you are losing this connection because of open path. In Q1 and Q2 both PMOS are off means both having open circuit. There is no way to connect with VDD. So in this case, as output is connecting with to ground, you are going to get 0 volts at output. If you observe this truth table, when you are providing at least one low input, then you are getting high output. Whenever all the inputs are high, then only you are going to get low voltage at output. That means this is the NAND functionality. This is NAND functionality. That means 1 into 0 whole bar 1, 0 into 1 whole bar 1, 0 into 0 whole bar 1, 1 into 1 whole bar 0. So we can say that by observing this truth table came from this circuit, so we can say that this will works as NAND gate. So this is the designing of CMOS NAND gate. So CMOS design is nothing but integrating PMOS with NMOS, PMOS structure as pull up and NMOS structure as pull down. So like this way we can design any circuit in CMOS functionality, CMOS logic by using.